Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Nidhi Singh, research scholar in Kalodia's University. Today I am presenting here explosive classification characteristic IEDs examination of explosive residue in laboratory. Indian Laboratory Act, explosives. Explosives are one of the most innovative things known to man. Explosive materials are chemicals or a mixture of chemicals, which when suitably initiated decompose with the rapid formation of large volume of hot gases. These gases can create extremely high pressure if the explosive is set off in a limited space. Explosives may be solid, liquid or gelatinous substances. Characteristics of explosives. Explosives have four basic characteristics. It is a chemical mixture ignited by heat, shock, impact or friction. On ignition, they decomposes rapidly in detonation. There is a rapid release of heat and large quantities of high pressure gases that expand rapidly with great force to overcome confining forces. The energy released by detonation of explosive produces four basic effects. One, rock fermentation, rock displacement, ground vibration and air blast. Detonation of the explosive charge causes a high velocity shock wave and a tremendous release of gas. The shock wave cracks and crushes the rock near the explosive and create thousands of cracks in the rock. These cracks are then filled with the expanding gases. The gases continue to fill and expand the cracks until the gas pressure is too weak to expand the cracks any further or are vented from the rock. Use of explosive compounds. Blasting holes in mountain for the construction of tunnels, excavation earth for dams, drilling of wells, seismic prospecting, dislodging rock, quarrying limestone for used in road construction, blasting ores of iron and other metals, breaking down coal, metal forming, etc. History of explosives. In 668 AD, Greek fire used in battle. 850 AD, Chinese invent gunpowder. In 1200 AD, Arabian author Abd Allah records use of saltpeter as main ingredient of black powder. In 1242, English friar Roger Bacon publishes gunpowder formula. In 1380, German Franciscan monk Berthold Schwartz developed gunpowder and it used in guns. In 1675, first powder mill in USA constructed in Milton, Massachusetts. In 1750, American inventor Benjamin Franklin encases and compresses powder in cartridges. In 1846, Italian chemist Ascanio Sobrero discovered nitroglycerin. In 1863, Willebrand invents nitrotoluene, TNT. In 1864, Swedish inventor Alfred Nobel developed first detonating blasting cap. In 1866, Swedish chemist Alfred Nobel invents dynamite by mixing Kesselgur with nitroglycerin. In 1875, Nobel patent blasting gelatin. In 1888, Nobel invents ballasted a dense smokeless powder. In 1902, detonating cord introduced in Europe. In 1907, consumption of black powder in US more than 287 million pounds. 1940, 51 mile Panama Canal opens, largest engineering project to date using more than 67 million pounds of dynamite. In 1938, modern PETN filled fabric covered detonating cord introduced in US. In 1940s, World War II drives propellant and explosive productions. In 1990s, present current drive to develop green explosives, more stable combination of existing explosive. Classification of explosives. Explosive may be classified according to their chemical structure, their use, their places in the detonation chain, explosive properties. According to the use of explosives, military explosive, they are TNT, PETN, RDX, industrial or commercial explosive, dynamite and AN. Emulsion explosive, illegally manufactured improvised explosives, TATP, triacetone, triperoxide, potassium chlorate and sugar mixture. According to the place in detonating chain, now the primary explosives, mercury fulminate, lead stiffenate, lead azide, dinol and boosters, PETN, main charges, TNT and RDX. According to explosive properties, high explosives, PETN, RDX, low explosives, propellants, smokeless powders, black powder, etc. Low explosives deflagrate rather than the detonate. Their reaction velocities are 2000 to less than 3000 feet per second. Black powder is a good example. These materials normally have little water resistance, are highly flammable and sensitive to friction. Low explosives generally do not fragment rock as well as high explosive. High explosives are detonating explosives. A high explosive is any chemical mixture that detonates with a reaction velocity over 5000 feet per second. High explosives have been subdivided into two groups according to their function in the explosive train. Therefore, that is primary explosives and secondary explosives. Primary explosives, these are the explosives used to start or initiate the explosion. These compounds are highly sensitive to mechanical shock, friction and heat, and readily ignited by direct contact with flame or electrical sparks. The main function of primary explosive is initiate a secondary explosive by shock wave. Because of their sensitivity, they are used in small quantities. Initiators are mainly used in military detonators, industrial blasting caps and shock primers. Now the mercury fulminate. It is colorless crystals. Empirical formula is C2N2O2Hg. Molecular weight 284 grams. Mercury fulminate is a heavy non-hygroscopic crystalline solid. It is the thermally unstable and very sensitive to impact, friction, spark, flame and shock. When dry, it reacts with metals such as arsenic, aluminium, magnesium, zinc, brass and bronze in moist atmosphere. Being a mercury derivative, it is a toxic compound, practically insoluble in water. Now the lead azide, PbN3 whole 2, insoluble in water, it is colorless crystals, molecular weight is 291.3. Lead azide has high temperature of ignition and less sensitive to shock and friction than mercury fulminate. It has good stability to heat and storage. Due to its high temperature of ignition, it is generally used in primary mixtures with lead. Stiffenate, which is very easy to ignite. Its contact with copper must be avoided because it leads to the formation of copper azide. Since it is a non-conductor, it may be mixed with flaked graphite to form a conductive mixture for use in low energy electrical detonation. Now the lead stiffenate. Lead trinitroresorcinate. It is orange, yellow to dark brown crystals. Its empirical formula is C6H3N3O9 Pb. molecular weight is 468.3. It is the thermally stable, non-corrosive and non-hygroscopic. It is sensitive to flame and electrostatic discharge. It is therefore used to sensitive load lead azide and initiate burning in primer composition. Practically insoluble in water, and it's sparingly soluble in acetone and ethanol, insoluble in ether, chloroform, benzene and toluene. Tetrazine, it is feathery, colorless to pale yellow crystals. Empirical formula is C2H8N10O. Molecular weight is 1888.2. It is slightly hygroscopic and explodes readily from flame, producing a large amount of smoke. It decomposes in boiling water. It ignites readily and is slightly more sensitive to impact than mercury fulminate. Practically insoluble in water, alcohol, ether, benzene and carbon, tetrachlorides. Secondary explosives. They are generally used as the main charge. Picric acid, yellow crystals. Empirical formula is C6H3N3O7. Molecular weight is 229.1, soluble in hot water and readily soluble in alcohol, ether, benzene and acetone. It was used in large caliber shells in World War I. In World War II, a mixture of ammonium picrate and TNT was widely used in the loading of armor shells. Now, the TNT. TNT stands for trinitrotoluene. TNT is the most widely used military explosive. Its main features includes low melting point stability, low sensitive to impact frictions and high temperature, and its relative safe method of manufacture, superior to explosive based on picric acid. The use of TNT was highly successful, not only as pure filling but the end of World War I, as the mixture with ammonium nitrate to give the explosive known as ametol contain as much as 80% ammonium nitrate. Now the tetryl, it is 2,4,6 trinitrophenyl ethyl nitramine. It is pale yellow in color. It is crystalline in nature. Crystal formula is C7H5N5O8. Molecular weight is 287.1. It is used in military boosters. Practically insoluble in water, sparingly soluble in alcohol, ether and benzene, and is more readily soluble in acetone. Now the PETN, it stands for pentaerythrotetranitrate. It is soluble in water, sparingly soluble in alcohol, ether and benzene, and soluble in acetone and methyl acetate. It is colorless in nature, crystalline in nature, and empirical formula is C5H8N4O12. Molecular weight is 316.1. It is used as a base charge in blasting caps and detonators, used as explosives in detonating cord, in booster charges, in plastic explosive, and as an ingredient in other explosives. PETN is highly stable and is considered to be more stable than all other nitrate esters. Next one is RDX. It is cyclotrimethyl trinitramine. It is soluble in acetone, insoluble in water and sparingly soluble in ether and ethanol. It is colorless, crystalline in nature. Empirical formula is C3H6N6O6. Molecular weight is 222.1. Melting point is 204 degrees Celsius. It is also known as cyclonite and hexogen. It is one of the most important military explosives used today. It has high chemical stability, lower than that of TNT, and an explosive power much greater than TNT. RDS is considerably more susceptible than TNT to shock detonation. RDX is used as component in mixture with other explosives such as TNT, and as the plastic explosives, a well-known plastic explosive Semtex is based on RDX and PETN. Mixture of RDX and wax are used for booster charges in many military ammunitions, especially in artillery shells. Now, the residual traces of explosive can be remains for long period of time. The explosive oil, nitroglycerin and ethylene glycol dinitrate have been recovered as long as 5 years after initial deposit. Free flowing particulate explosive like black and smokeless powder remain indefinitely if not physically removed. Explosive traces on material, for example, nitrate esters, has a greater affinity for protein based of similar material such as wool, or for plastic such as acrylics, polyester or nylon carpeting. Now, the low explosives require confinement, typically a pipe, and initiation either with a fuse or hot wire capable of reaching the initiation temperature of the explosive. The reaction proceeds with a particle to particle transmission of the deflagrating front. As the pressure and temperature rise, the rate of the reaction also increases until the pressure exceeds the bursting strength of the container. At this point, pressure is rapidly released, the reaction rate rapidly decreases, and unconsumed particles are ejected from the container. Such recovered particles can provide the info regarding manufacturer and brand of explosive. Yes. Suspect is subsequently identified. Recovered particles can be compared to powder in the suspect possession. The most efficient manner to collect low explosive particles is physical sweeping. Clean unused broom and dustpan, or mechanical vacuuming, clean unused of the blast seat. Microscopic examination frequently reveals unconsumed low explosives. High energy explosive residues at site is in trace amounts. Extraction of explosives. The exhibits received in connection with the pre-blast and post-blast cases are subjected to a detailed systematic analysis. Extraction of debris by organic solvent transfers the explosive residues into the solution. Now, the organic solvent extraction. Acetone is universally accepted broad spectrum solvent. Other organic solvents like ether, benzene and chloroform are also used, which are suitable for certain groups of organic explosives. Nitro aromatic and some nitrate esters like EGDN or NG. The explosive like the heterocyclic nitroamines, RDX and HMX are practically insoluble in these solvents. Solubility of RDX is 8.2 gram per 100 grams, HMX 2.9 grams per 100 grams, both at 25 degrees Celsius, PETN 20.3 grams per 100 grams at 20 degrees Celsius. Sometimes methanol or other solvents of their mixture may be used instead of acetone. The extract are concentrated and subjected to various analytical tests for detection and identification of organic explosives. Water extract. The residue left after acetone extract is treated with hot water and filtered. The organic residue dissolves readily in hot water. The water extract is concentrated to a small volume. Chemical and other analytical tests are performed for the detection of water-soluble ingredients. Alkali extract. The residue left after water extraction often include metals sulfides of arsenic and antimony, etc. A small portion of the dried material is extracted with two normal NaOH, that is sodium hydroxide, and filtered. The filtrate is preserved for the detection of sulfide, arsenic, antimony, aluminium, etc. Now, the pyridine extract. The residue left after above extraction is dried and extracted with pyridine and filtered. The extract is preserved for detection of elemental sulfur. The detection and identification of explosive. Primary examination of whole sample is carried out for odor, color, consistency, and any visually observable ingredients. Ingredients with characteristic odor, such as mononitrotoluene, may often be detected at this stage. The color and consistency may guide to find the general type of particular explosive. Some ingredients, such as blown off aluminium, can be readily identified by their characteristic appearance. Visible contaminants can also be observed at this stage. Instrumental analysis. Following instrumental techniques are helpful in detection of the explosive compounds recovered from scene of incidents. Gas liquid chromatography, high performance liquid chromatography, mass spectrophotometry, and FTIR, SEM, EDX, and XRF. Thank you.